Hello, do you know that Genesis is not part of the Old Testament? Yes, Genesis is not part of the Old Testament. So also the book of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, and John, they are not part of the New Testament books of the Bible. In this edition of Discussing Issue, we'll be looking at the dichotomy of Old Testament and New Testament and how to accurately divide the word of truth. Join us in this episode. My name is Omoyele Yinka. God bless you. You are welcome. Bible told us that we need to study to show ourselves approved unto God. A workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. One of the ways to rightly divide the word of truth is to understand the dichotomy between the Old Testament and the New Testament. So when we are looking at the letter of the word of God, we are looking at the subdivision of the Bible into Old and New Testament. Oftentimes, when people want to bring up doctrine, they generalize the Old Testament to be the book of Genesis to Malachi, and they generalize the book of New Testament to be from Matthew to the book of Revelation. This is not an accurate division of the Word of God. For us to divide the Bible rightly, we must understand what is called the Old Covenant. The Old Covenant actually started in the book of Exodus, and the progenitor of this covenant was Moses. Moses was the one that birthed the Old Covenant when he took the blood and he sprinkled it upon the people. In the book of Exodus chapter 24 verse 8, Bible told us that Moses sprinkled the blood upon the people and he said, "This is the blood of the covenant that God made between them." Now, when we are talking about covenant, or you are talking about the Old Covenant, we are talking about the will, or what we call the agreement that God has with the people of Israel. Israelites as a nation enter into covenant with God, and this covenant is called Old Covenant. And this Old Covenant took place in Exodus. Before a nation called Israel was born, there has been a period in time that precedes that, and God has been relating with people. And that relationship of God with people that we are now enjoying, it started with Abraham. So God told Abraham to leave his father's house and into a land that he has promised him. The journey of faith that we are all in today started with Abraham. And Abraham was not under Old Covenant when God started the relationship with him. So it's not accurate to assume that Genesis is part of the Old Covenant. I call Genesis pre-Old Covenant book, or a book that precedes the Old Covenant. In the same vein, it is not accurate for us to conclude that Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John is New Testament. New Testament is the testament that was brought in because God found fault with the Old Covenant. And this testament has a progenitor called Jesus Christ our Lord. And Jesus established this covenant by his blood. And this covenant is meant for the church. And when you look critically to the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, it's still part of the Old Covenant. Because in this fourth book of the gospel, it explained to us the life and the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. The church was actually born in the book of Acts. So when we are talking about covenant, Bible told us clearly in the book of Hebrew that as long as a testator is alive, the testament is of no use, or it cannot be enforced. That testament can be called will. If a man has will and he has established a will for his children, you will realize that that will be of no consequence until that man dies. So the same way Jesus needs to die for the new covenant to come. The new covenant actually started when the apostle received the baptism of the Holy Spirit. So Matthew, Mark, Luke, John are still part of the Old Covenant. It's just a preparatory book for the new covenant. How do we establish this? Bible told us in the book of Galatians chapter 4 that even Jesus Christ was a man that was born under the law. So Jesus operated his life as someone that is under the law of Moses. And that was why we realized that Jesus fulfilled all the law. He made sure that he went into the temple when he's supposed to be. That was why when Jesus was born, he was made to go through the rite of the law. So Jesus was under the law when he came. He fulfilled all the tenets of the law. So it is safe to say that Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John was not actually part of the New Testament. So when we are talking about New Testament, we are talking about books from Acts of Apostles to the book of Revelation. And when we are talking about the Old Testament, we are talking about book from Exodus and possibly to the book of Malachi. We still need to understand that there are some books of the Bible that we refer to as the Old Covenant book that are actually historical books, although they bear in mind the relationship of Israel under the Old Covenant. So anytime we are bringing up a doctrine from the Bible, we need to ask ourselves, this doctrine, is it in relation to the people of Israel as part of the Old Covenant tenet, or does it have something to do with our father Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob? Whatever God established with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob cannot be categorized as Old Covenant. Take, for instance, the issue of Sabbath, the issue of tithing, and some other practices that we now have, we realize that we take them either from Genesis or from Exodus. So there's a need for us to draw the line of dichotomy between what precedes the law and what is in the law. In the New Testament as well, we realize that Jesus will not allow anybody to publicly call him Christ throughout the book of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Although we saw instances that Peter told him that thou art Christ, the Son of the living God. In that instance, Jesus revealed to them that this revelation came from Father, but he warned them that they should tell no man. The reason is because Christ needs to die, he needs to resurrect before he can be called Christ. And at that point in time, Jesus has not died. He's planning to die, he's planning to go to the grave, he's planning to come back again. So while he's fulfilling that, he will not allow anybody to jump the gun and say he is Christ. So it's very important for us to know that after resurrection, Jesus now commissioned them to go and tell people that the same Jesus they crucified, he has become Christ. So when we are talking about the new covenant, we are talking about the covenant that God made with his church, in which Jesus has become Christ. He brought us into that relationship to be called the children of God. This covenant of Christ is superior to the old covenant because in this covenant, we are brought into the family of God. So we can be called the sons and the daughters of the living God. And that was why God said, I will make a covenant with them, not after the old. So when we are in the new covenant, we need to understand that we are resting upon the finished work of Christ. We are not slaves in the house of God, but we are children of God. Brethren, we would like to conclude this episode by letting us know that anytime we want to establish doctrine in the Bible, or anytime you want to follow a particular doctrine, you need to ask yourself a simple question. Is this doctrine based upon the Old Covenant, or is this something that precedes the Old Covenant? In the next episode, we'll be doing more study in this dimension of the Old and the New Covenant, while we are looking at some established doctrine in the body of Christ, such as the doctrine of tithing and the doctrine of Sabbath. Till then, share this video among your friends and let us meet together again. My name is Omoyele Yinka. God bless you.